Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. Mazda is a small automobile manufacturer. This table shows the global sales figures by automobile manufacturer for 2024. Mazda's exact ranking is unknown, but its sales amount to only 54% of those of 15th-ranked Mercedes-Benz. Yet this small automaker has adopted as many as 5 different types of hybrid systems. Furthermore, another type of system is expected to be added next year. We could say it's already in disarray, and that wouldn't be an exaggeration. In this video, we'll explore 6 types of hybrid systems and consider the future direction of a small yet distinctive automobile manufacturer that still produces rotary engines and lightweight 2-seat roadster. Mazda 3 and CX-30 are equipped with a mild hybrid system that uses an ISG, integrated starter generator. This video provides a brief overview of mild hybrid systems with an ISG. But the channel also offers a more detailed video that explains them in depth. If you're interested, please check it out. There's a link in the description. An ISG is a device that integrates the traditional alternator and starter motor. It performs 3 functions: acting as a generator when the engine is running, as a starter motor when starting the engine, and as a drive motor that assists the engine during launch and acceleration. This type of ISG transmits power via a belt, which is why it's referred to as a BSG, belt-driven ISG. The primary purpose of the earliest BSG systems was to restart the engine after it had been shut off by the stop-start system, while assisting engine output is thought to have been a secondary objective. Therefore, the electricity driving the BSG remained at 12 volts, resulting in low BSG output and only minimal engine assist. Afterwards, to deliver stronger engine assist, high-output 48-volt BSG systems were introduced primarily by European automakers. However, because power transmission via a rubber belt cannot handle high torque, systems were also developed that place a higher-output ISG between the engine and transmission. Mazda 3 and CX-30 feature a BSG-type mild hybrid system. BSG-type mild hybrid systems are used in many vehicles, but Mazda's system has a distinctive feature. We will compare it with other models. Volkswagen Golf is equipped with a 48-volt BSG that produces 14 kilowatt and 56 newton-meter of torque. The engine is a 1.5-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder, producing 110 kilowatt and 250 newton-meter of torque. Since the vehicle's electrical system remains at 12 volts, it is equipped with a converter that steps down 48 volts to 12 volts. Suzuki Swift is equipped with a 12-volt BSG system, primarily designed for restarting the engine after it has been stopped by the start-stop function, similar to the earliest BSG systems. Therefore, the BSG has a low output of 2.3 kilowatt and 60 newton-meter. The engine is a 1.2-liter naturally aspirated 3-cylinder, producing 60 kilowatt and 108 newton-meter of torque. Needless to say, there's no need for a voltage converter. Mazda uses a 24-volt BSG with an output of 5.1 kilowatt and 49 newton-meter. The engine is either a 2.5-liter or 2.0-liter naturally aspirated 4-cylinder, with a 2.0-liter engine producing 115 kilowatt and 199 newton-meter of torque. A converter from 24 volts to 12 volts is required. Since a 24-volt BSG still requires the cost of a voltage converter just like a 48-volt system, why did Mazda choose to use a lower output 24-volt BSG? Is it because its design is older? Let's look into it. Mazda 3 was launched in 2019, just like Golf. The previous generation Mercedes-Benz C-Class and the current Audi A8, both equipped with 48-volt BSGs, were launched in 2018. Several years prior to that, automotive parts manufacturers had been actively promoting 48-volt electrical systems. They should have known that European manufacturers were developing 48-volt mild hybrid systems. The truth is known only to insiders at Mazda. Ford uses a hybrid system that employs a planetary gear set. This system is similar to Toyota's, but it was developed independently by them. Subaru also uses a hybrid system with planetary gears. It is their own design based on Toyota's system. Mazda has adopted Toyota's system in their CX-50. This isn't just a system similar to Toyota's, nor is it one developed using Toyota's technology. It's the actual Toyota system, used without modification. They've carried over the A25 AFXS engine, transaxle, and electric motor from Toyota RAV4 directly into the CX-50. The engine produces 176 horsepower at 5,300 revolutions per minute, with a compression ratio of 14 to 1. The front electric motor delivers 118 horsepower and 149 pound-feet of torque, while the rear motor outputs 54 horsepower and 89 pound-feet of torque. The specifications of the CX-50 are completely identical to those of Toyota RAV4. It's common for automobile manufacturers to source engines and transmissions from others. But Mazda, is that really okay? This channel offers detailed videos explaining the hybrid systems of Toyota and Subaru. If you're interested, please check it out. There's a link in the description. MX-30 has three different types of powertrains. They are a mild hybrid, a battery EV, and a series type PHEV, plug-in hybrid electric vehicle, that uses a rotary engine. However, some models have already been discontinued in certain markets. The mild hybrid model uses a system similar to that of the Mazda 3 and CX-30, combining a 2.0-liter naturally aspirated four-cylinder engine with a BSG. The battery EV model is equipped with a 125 kilowatts electric motor and a relatively small 35.5 kilowatt hours battery. The series hybrid model combines a 0.83 liter rotary engine producing 53 kilowatts, a 107 kilowatts electric motor, and a 17.8 kilowatt hours battery. In this hybrid system, the rotary engine is used exclusively for generating electricity and cannot be used to drive the wheels at highway driving, unlike the systems from Honda, Mitsubishi, or BYD. A hybrid system without a direct engine drive mode paired with a rotary engine that has poor fuel efficiency. Where is the MX-30 hybrid model really headed? If you want to learn more about the direct engine drive mode in series hybrid systems, please watch this video. The link is in the description. Mazda employs two types of hybrid systems in CX-60, 70, 80, and 90. The PHEV is paired with a 2.5 liters naturally aspirated four-cylinder engine. The hybrid system is a parallel-type hybrid that combines a drive motor, an engine disengagement clutch, and an automatic transmission. The engine produces 138 kilowatts and 250 newton-meters of torque, while the drive motor delivers 129 kilowatts and 270 newton-meters. The transmission is an 8-speed stepped automatic that uses a hydraulic clutch instead of a torque converter. In EV mode, the engine disengagement clutch is disengaged, allowing the vehicle to run using only the drive motor. In hybrid mode, the clutch is engaged, and the engine and drive motor are combined depending on driving conditions. We will compare it with other vehicles in the same category. Please note that all the data is for Japan spec vehicles. Mazda CX-60 uses a parallel hybrid system. Toyota RAV4 uses a power split hybrid system with a planetary gear set. And Mitsubishi Outlander uses a series hybrid system with a direct engine drive mode. All the engines are naturally aspirated four-cylinder units, with Mazda and Toyota having a displacement of 2.5 liters and Mitsubishi 2.4 liters. The vehicle weights are 2,080 kilograms for Mazda, 1,900 kilograms for Toyota, and 2,140 kilograms for Mitsubishi. The engine outputs are 138 kilowatts and 250 newton meters for Mazda, 130 kilowatts and 219 newton meters for Toyota, and 98 kilowatts and 195 newton meters for Mitsubishi. Mazda's motor outputs are 129 kilowatts and 270 newton meters. For Toyota, the front motor produces 134 kilowatts and 270 newton meters, and the rear motor produces 40 kilowatts and 121 newton meters. Mitsubishi's front motor outputs 85 kilowatts and 255 newton meters, while the rear motor delivers 100 kilowatts and 195 newton meters. Fuel efficiency in hybrid mode. The WLTC mode fuel economy for this market does not include the extra high-speed phase at 130 km per hour. Therefore, the highway phase value is for speeds up to 100 km per hour. Toyota stands out thanks to its ability to optimally combine the engine and drive motor. Mitsubishi follows with an engine dedicated to power generation, while Mazda, whose system is more of an extension of conventional engine-driven vehicles, lags slightly behind in terms of fuel efficiency. This system consists of a six-cylinder gasoline or diesel engine, an engine disengagement clutch, a 48-volt electric motor, and an eight-speed stepped automatic transmission equipped with a hydraulic multi-plate clutch instead of a torque converter. The motor has low output, but the system configuration is almost the same as that of the PHEV model. The 3.3 liters gasoline turbo engine produces 209 kilowatts and 450 newton meters of torque, while the 3.3 liters diesel turbo engine delivers 187 kilowatts and 550 newton meters. The electric motor produces 12 kilowatts and 153 newton meters of torque. The 48-volt mild hybrid systems, used by Stellantis Group brands such as Citroën and Fiat, as well as Audi, are equipped with an engine disengagement clutch, allowing the electric motor to handle driving from a standstill to low speeds. Mazda's system is also equipped with an engine disengagement clutch, but electric motor driving is limited and only occurs under specific conditions, such as steady cruising on highways. This channel offers detailed videos explaining the 48-volt mild hybrid systems used by Stellantis and Audi. If you're interested, please check them out. The links are in the description. The Japanese lineup includes a 3.3 liters diesel engine model and a version that combines the same engine with a mild hybrid system. So let's compare the two. The diesel model weighs 1,870 kilograms, while the hybrid model weighs 1,930 kilograms. The hybrid model is heavier by the weight of the battery and electric motor. The engine output is 170 kilowatts and 500 newton meters for the diesel model, and 187 kilowatts and 550 newton meters for the hybrid model. It is unclear whether the 10% higher output of the hybrid model is due to technical reasons or commercial considerations. Fuel economy. In every phase, the hybrid model's fuel economy is about 10 to 15% better. This serves as evidence that even mild hybrids, which rarely shut off the engine, can achieve this level of fuel economy improvement. However, since the vehicle price also increases, whether this improvement is worth it is up to you. Mazda has announced that the next generation CX-5 will be equipped with its independently developed strong hybrid system. Other than the fact that it's for a transverse engine, independently developed, and a strong hybrid, nothing else is known. The most reasonable assumption would be that the longitudinal mild hybrid system has been upgraded to a higher voltage and paired with a transverse transmission. However, Mazda is the only manufacturer in the world to have successfully commercialized technologies like the rotary engine and the SPCCI, spark-controlled compression ignition engine. They just might surprise us with a truly astonishing hybrid system. Let's look forward to the launch of the CX-5. By next year, Mazda will have no fewer than six different hybrid systems, something unprecedented anywhere else in the world. And no, that's not a compliment. It's meant sarcastically. What kind of product lineup will they offer going forward? The series hybrid with the rotary engine, which has been commercially unsuccessful, probably won't last very long. If a new system for the CX-5 is introduced, the Toyota system currently used in the CX-50 will likely become unnecessary. In that case, it's reasonable to assume that transverse engine vehicles will adopt the system currently under development, while longitudinal engine vehicles will continue to use the existing mild hybrid and PHEV systems. What do you think about it? Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.